pituitarism. So, inadequate production of anterior pituitary hormones, it leads to features of hypopituitarism. Impaired production of one, it because of impaired production of one or more of the anterior pituitary trophic hormone. It can result from inherited disorders, and more commonly, adult hypopituitarism is acquired. So, more commonly, it is acquired more than inherited. It requires acquired is mostly the compressive mass effects of tumors because of local pituitary, hypothalamic, traumatic, or inflammatory vascular damage. Okay, I'm running it through because we will just check the table, just striking everything out. So, etiology of hypopituitarism. Just a sec. So, etiology of hypopituitarism. Developmental or structural defects, traumatic, neoplastic, infiltrative, inflammatory, vascular, and infections. Development or structural defects. It can be transcription factor defect, pituitary dysplasia or aplasia, any congenital CNS mass or encephalocele, primary empty cella. It can be congenital hypothalamic disorders like septo-optic dysplasia, Prader-Willi, Bardet-Biedl syndrome and Kallmann syndrome. Traumatic can be because of surgical resection, radiation damage or head injuries. Neoplastic because of pituitary adenoma compressing the structures, paracellar mass which can be geminoma, ependymoma and glioma. Rutke's cyst, craniopharyngioma, hypothalamic hematoma or gangliocytoma. Pituitary metastasis from breast, lung or colon cancers. Leukemia, lymphoma and meningiomas. Infiltrative causes can be lymphocytic hypophysitis, hemochromatosis, sarcoid, histiocytosis, X, granulomatous hypophysitis, transcription factor antibodies and immunotherapy. Vascular pituitary apoplexy, pregnancy related, that is infarction with diabetes and postpartum necrosis. This is Sheehan syndrome. Then the sickle cell disease, okay, and arteritis. Infection, fungal, histoplasma, parasite, toxoplasma, TB and pneumocystis jeroboeci. So, going through the etiology again, it can be developmental or structural defect, that is transcription factor defect, ya to organ bana hi nahi, aplasia, dysplasia, pituitary, then congenital any CNS congenital mass like encephalocele, primary empty cella, syndromes like Kallmann syndrome, Prader-Willi, Bardet-Biedl syndrome. Any traumatic, of course, post-surgery, post-radiation and because of head injury. Neoplastic, most common should be pituitary adenoma, any other paracellar mass, geminoma, ependymoma, glioma, Rutke's cyst, craniopharyngioma. Then any hypothalamic hematoma, gangliocytoma, any pituitary metastasis from lung, colon cancer, breast cancer, any lymphoma, leukemia and meningiomas. Infiltrative and inflammatory. So inflammatory may either be lymphocytic hypophysitis. Others are infiltrative are hemochromatosis, sarcoidosis, histiocytosis X, granulomatous hypophysitis. Okay. हाँ ये भी अपना inflammatory है. Transcription factor antibodies और immunotherapy. Vascular में arteritis, sickle cell disease, pregnancy related उसमें infection होता है, Sheehan syndrome and pituitary apoplexy. Is okay. Apoplexy is another name for stroke. Infection is fungal, histoplasmosis, parasitic is toxoplasmosis, tuberculosis and PCP. Okay. You can take a moment to have a look at all these. Fine. So, going in details of each one, developmental and genetic causes. So, pituitary dysplasia. Pituitary dysplasia may result in aplastic, hypoplastic or ectopic pituitary development. Because pituitary development follows a midline cell migration from the nasopharyngeal Rutke's pouch, the midline craniofacial disorders may be associated with pituitary dysplasia, right? So, pituitary dysplasia is associated with midline craniofacial disorders. Acquired pituitary failure in newborn can be because of a birth trauma, including cranial hemorrhage, asphyxia or breech delivery. Okay, so that is pituitary dysplasia. Then septo-optic dysplasia, it is hypothalamic dysfunction and hypopituitarism. So, primary there is hypothalamus ka dysfunction. So septo-optic mein hypothalamic dysfunction giving rise to hypopituitarism because of dysgenesis of the septum pellucidum or corpus callosum, right? Affected children have mutation in HESX1 gene, which is involved in early development of ventral prosencephalon. Okay. These children exhibit cleft palate, syndactyly, ear deformities, hypertelorism, optic nerve, hypoplasia, micropenes, and anosmia because the olfactory nerve endings over there. Okay, pituitary dysfunction leads to diabetes insipidus, growth hormone deficiency, short stature, and TSH deficiency. So going through septo-optic dysplasia again, there is hypothalamic dysfunction giving rise to hypopituitary. That is because of dyssynergies of septum pellucidum that will further form the corpus callosum. It is affecting in children with HES-X1 gene. Okay, which is involved in early development of ventral prosencephalon. Okay, so cleft palate, syndactyly, ear deformities, facial features basically, hypertelorism, optic nerve hypoplasia, then there will be micropenes and anosmia. And also pituitary dysfunction will give rise to diabetes insipidus, growth hormone deficiency, and short stature. Of course, TSH deficiency also, hypopituitarism. Then there are tissue factor mutation, tissue specific factor mutation. So several pituitary translation factors, we have read through this one before, PIT1 and PROP1, they are critical for development and maintaining function of the differentiated pituitary cell lineages. So autosomal dominant or recessive PIT1 mutation can give rise to GH, prolactin, and TSH deficiencies. They give rise to growth failure and varying degrees of hypothyroidism. The pituitary may appear hypoplastic on MRI. So PIT1 causes defects in GH, prolactin, and TSH. Okay, then there is PROP1. PROP1 is expressed early in pituitary development and appears to be, PROP1 is required for PIT1 to function, right? PROP1 is, these PIT1 and PROP1 are coming in every subsequent answer, that is why I am stressing more on this. So, PROP1 is required for PIT1 to function. So, familial and sporadic PROP1 mutation is again GH, prolactin, TSH, and PROP1 mein addition ho gaya hai gonadotropin ka. GH, prolactin, and TSH PIT1 mein bhi the, PROP1 mein you would like to add gonadotropin. Okay. Over 80% of these patients will have growth retardation, and by adulthood all will be deficient in TSH and gonadotropin, and similarly, and some minority later may develop ACTH deficiency also. So I would like to add ACTH also here. So growth hormone, prolactin, and TSH is common for both. Gonadotropin and ACTH is added in PROP1. Because of gonadotropin deficiency, these do not enter puberty spontaneously. In some cases, the pituitary gland appears enlarged. TPIT mutation, yeah, and the third one is TPIT. So number one is PIT1, number two is PROP1, and number three is TPIT. TPIT mutation, TPIT is only for ACTH deficiency and associated with hypocortisolism. Okay. Fine. Okay. So, factor mutation, transcription factor mutation mein PIT1 hai, PROP1 hai, aur TPIT hai. TPIT is only for ACTH. Okay. Now, developmental hypothalamic dysfunction, we will go through each one separately. So, Kallmann syndrome. Kallmann syndrome is very important from especially the MCQ point of view. So, let me just highlight Kallmann syndrome. So, Kallmann syndrome results from defective hypothalamic GnRH synthesis. Okay, defective. So, basically, defect is in the hypothalamus. And defective hypothalamic GnRH synthesis, gonadotropin releasing hormone synthesis, it is associated with anosmia and hypoosmia. Point number one was hypothalamic GnRH synthesis. Point number two is anosmia and hypoosmia because olfactory bulb agenesis or hypoplasia. Okay, so classically the syndrome may be associated with, so one nose ho gaya, anosmia, hypoosmia, abhi eye ka hai, color blindness, optic atrophy, fir kaan, nerve deafness, cleft palate, renal abnormalities. Okay, renal abnormality, cryptorchidism, and neurologic abnormality such as mirror movements. Okay, so first point is hypothalamic GnRH synthesis mein deficiency. Second is olfactory bulb hypoplasia, to anosmia, hyposmia hota hi hai. Fir eyes pe aa jao, color blindness and optic atrophy, ears, इज नर्व डेफनेस, फिर है क्लेफ्ट पैलेट नंबर 5, 6 इज रीनल अबनॉर्मेलिटीज, क्रिप्टोर्किडिज्म 7 एंड न्यूरोलॉजिकल मूवमेंट्स मिरर मूवमेंट्स 8. द इनिशियल जेनेटिक कॉज वॉज आइडेंटिफाइड इन द एक्स लिंक कालजीन. लेट मी जस्ट हाईलाइट दिस एक्स लिंक कालजीन. म्यूटेशंस ऑफ विच इम्पेयर द एम्ब्रियोनिक माइग्रेशन ऑफ GnRH न्यूरोन फ्रॉम द हाइपोथैलेमिक ऑल्फैक्ट्री प्लकोट टू द हाइपोथैलेमस. सो बेसिकली म्यूटेशन ऑकर्स बिकॉज म्यूटेशन कॉजेज इम्पेयरमेंट ऑफ माइग्रेशन ऑफ द GnRH न्यूरोन फ्रॉम हाइपोथैलेमिक ऑल्फैक्ट्री प्लकोट टू हाइपोथैलेमस. ऑल्फैक्ट्री के एरिया से न्यूरोन्स माइग्रेट होते हैं प्रॉपर हाइपोथैलेमस में, तो वो माइग्रेशन में प्रॉब्लम है. ठीक है, माइग्रेशन ऑफ द GnRH न्यूरोन्स. Since then, at least a dozen of additional genetic abnormalities in addition to CALM mutation have been formed. Autosomal recessive GPR5, KIS1. This we also read in gonadotropin deficiency, same genes. KIS1, GPR54 and dominant, these are recessive. Dominant FGFR1 mode of transmission have been described. There is a growing list of genes. I think I'll just skip this. Some patients have oligogenic mutation associated clinical features in addition to GnRH deficiency vary depending on the genetic cause. GnRH deficiency prevents progression through puberty. Okay, so of course, male will have delayed puberty, pronounced hypogonadal features, micropenis probably because of low testosterone level during infancy, and females will present with primary amenorrhea and failure of sexual development. So this is the last point, gonadotropin deficiency in males and females. Male will cause delayed puberty, delayed puberty will be there in both, then micropenis because of low testosterone, and females primary amenorrhea and failure of secondary sexual development. Okay, so I also said renal abnormalities and cryptorchidism and neurological fact. Kallmann syndrome and other causes of congenital GnRH deficiency are characterized by, okay, so of course low LH and FSH and low concentration of sex steroids, that is testosterone and estrogen. In sporadic case of isolated gonadotropin deficiency, the diagnosis is often of exclusion after other known causes of hypothalamo-pituitary dysfunction. So basically this is a diagnosis of exclusion. Repetitive GnRH administration doge to normal pituitary gonadotropin response aayega, pointing to hypothalamic defect in these patients, right? Long term treatment of male with HCG or testosterone restores the pubertal development and secondary sexual characters. Women can be treated with cyclic estrogen and progesterone. Male ko long term HCG dena hai or testosterone, female ko FSH and LH. Fertility may be restored by administration of gonadotropin or by portable infusion pump to deliver pulsatile GnRH. These details we have read in gonadotropin deficiency syndrome. This is about Kallmann syndrome. So Calgene, X-linked it is, under X-linked Calgene. Okay, hypothalamic gonadotropin synthesis mein problem hai, hypos mein, toh ear, nose, face, everything. Okay, other than renal abnormalities are also there, cryptorchidism, then failure of secondary sexual characters is there. Okay, so there is defect in the migration of the GnRH neuron from hypothalamic olfactory region to the hypothalamus proper. So treatment mein, testosterone, FSH, LH, hormonal replacement de do. It will for secondary sexual characteristics and for fertility, we will give pulsatile GnRH every 2 hours through continuous infusion pump subcutaneously. Next is Bardet-Biedl syndrome. Bardet-Biedl syndrome, this is a very rare genetically heterogeneous disorder characterized by mental retardation, renal abnormalities and obesity and hexadactyly, brachydactyly or syndactyly. So usme Kallmann syndrome mein fingers ka kuch nahi tha, okay, na hi wo mentally retarded tha. Bardet-Biedl is mentally retarded, obese, there will be renal abnormalities. वहाँ पे वो मिरर न्यूरोलॉजिकल इफेक्ट्स में से एक ही एग्जांपल दिया था, मिरर मूवमेंट्स जो तुम करोगे वो सेम टू सेम वो करेगा. ठीक है, यहाँ पे मेंटल रिटार्डेशन, रीनल अबनॉर्मलिटी एंड फिंगर्स का, हेक्साडेक्टिली, ब्रैकिडेक्टिली और सिंडेक्टिली. सेंट्रल डायबिटिक इंसिपिटस मे और मे नॉट बी एसोसिएटेड. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट इज डायबिटीज इंसिपिटस. GnRH डेफिशिएंसी भी होता है इन 75% ऑफ मेल्स एंड हाफ ऑफ फीमेल्स. नेक्स्ट इज रेटिनल डीजनरेशन. Retinal degeneration begins in early childhood and most patients are blind by the age of 30. Okay. fine. So Bardet-Biedl syndrome, retinal degeneration and early in childhood, and most patients are blind by age of 30. Numerous subtypes of Bardet-Biedl syndromes have been identified with genetic leakages at least 9 different locus, several loci, genes involving basal body cilia function. This one, okay, let it be. So yeah, itna hi diya hai. Bardet-Biedl syndrome, mental retardation, renal abnormalities and fingers ka syndactyly, brachydactyly, extra hexadactyly. Central diabetes, GnRH deficiency, so features similar to the previous one. Retinal degeneration in early childhood and blind by age of 30. Then there is leptin and leptin receptor mutations. So deficiencies of leptin or leptin receptor can cause a broad spectrum of hypothalamic abnormalities. Yeah, so leptin is associated with our hunger thing. So it causes hyperphagia, obesity and central hypogonadism. So leptin and leptin wale mein hyperphagia zyada khayega, isliye mota hoega, hyperphagia, obesity and central hypogonadism. Decreased GnRH production rahega in this patient results to attenuated FSHLH. Okay. Then there is, next is Prader-Willi syndrome. Prader-Willi syndrome, it is a contiguous gene syndrome that results from deletion of paternal copies of imprinted SNRPN gene, NECDIN gene, and other gene on chromosome 15. Yes, deletion of paternal copy. So isme paternal copy, Prader-Willi mein paternal copy delete ho jata hai on the chromosome 15 of which gene? Of NECDIN gene, on SNRPN. Prader-Willi is associated with hypogonadotropic hypogonadism, hyperphagia, obesity, yes, similar to leptin wala, chronic muscle hypotonia, mental retardation, adult onset diabetes mellitus, multiple somatic defects, skull, eye, ear, hands and feet, diminished hypothalamic oxytocin and vasopressin producing nuclei. Okay, deficient GnRH synthesis is suggested by the observation that chronic GnRH treatment restores the FSHLS. ठीक है, तो इसमें बहुत कुछ है. एक तो क्रोमोसोम 15q का पैटर्नल कॉपी ऑफ पर्टिकुलर जीन इज डिलीटेड विद जीन SNRPN जीन, द NECDIN जीन. ओके फाइन. सो हाइपोगोनाडोट्रोपिक हाइपोगोनाडिज्म है, हाइपरफेजिया, ओबेसिटी है, मेंटली रिटार्डेड है, हाइपोटोनिया है, अडल्ट ऑनसेट डायबिटीज़ है, बाकी फेशियल, स्कल, आइज, ईयर्स सब कुछ डिफेक्ट है, डिफेक्टिव इन ऑक्सीटोसिन एंड वेसोप्रेसिन रिलीजिंग न्यूक्लियर ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज विद द इनहेरिटेड कॉजेज ऑफ हाइपोपिट्यूटरीज्म. लेट्स जस्ट टर्न द पेज एंड हैव अ लुक वंस अगेन. सो पिट्यूटरी डिस्प्लेजिया में आपने बोला था अप्लेजिया, हाइपोप्लेजिया या डिस्प्लेजिया हो सकता है. सिंस द पिट्यूटरी डेवलपमेंट इज फ्रॉम द मिडलाइन माइग्रेशन फ्रॉम द नेजोफेरिंजियल डट के स्पाउस, इसीलिए मिडलाइन क्रेनियोफेशियल डिसऑर्डर्स आर एसोसिएटेड. फिर सेप्टो ऑप्टिक डिस्प्लेजिया में तेरा सेप्टम पेल्यूसिडम और कॉर्पस कैलोजम डिफेक्टिव है, डिसजेनेसिस है, डिसजेनेसिस ऑफ सेप्टम पेल्यूसिडम और कॉर्पस कैलोजम. So this is because of the HSX1 gene which is required in the ventral prosencephalon ka ye. So usme cephalate, syndactyly, ear deformities, hypertelorism, optic nerve hypoplasia, micropenis, anosmia, diabetes insipidus, short stature, GSTS, it's sub deficiency. Basically, facial features and all you can write. Just remember, septum pellucidum, corpus callosum ka defect hai, HSX1 gene. Facial features likhna hai, GSTS deficiency. गोनाडोट्रोपिन डेफिशिएंसी भी है, राइट, माइक्रोपेनिस बोल दिया, डायबिटीज इंसिपिडस बोल दिया, तो अपना वेसोप्रेसन का भी है. फाइन, देन टिश्यू फैक्टर्स में पिट1, प्रॉप1 एंड टीपिट. पिट1 में है ग्रोथ हार्मोन, प्रोलैक्टिन और TSH ओनली. प्रॉप1 में है ये तीनों प्लस गोनाडोट्रोपिन एंड ACTH, ग्रोथ हार्मोन एंड TSH. एंड टीपिट में है सिर्फ ACTH डेफिशिएंसी. ओके, और ये सारे ट्रांसक्रिप्शन फैक्टर्स हैं. प्रॉप1 इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर पिट1 ऑल्सो. फिर डेवलपमेंटल हाइपोथैलेमिक डिसफंक्शन सिंड्रोम्स में कैलमैन सिंड्रोम है, Bardet-Biedl है, Prader-Willi है एंड लेप्टिन रिसेप्टर म्यूटेशन है. तो कैलमैन सिंड्रोम वी नो, हाइपोथैलेमिक GnRH सिंथेसिस नहीं हो रहा है विथ एनोस्मिया, हाइपोस्मिया, ठीक है, कलर ब्लाइंडनेस, ऑप्टिक एट्रोफी, नर्व डेफनेस, देन देयर इज क्लेफ्ट पैलेट, रीनल अबनॉर्मेलिटीज, न्यूरोलॉजिकल अबनॉर्मेलिटीज, मिरर मूवमेंट्स, एंड देन देर इज हाइपोगोनाडोट्रोपिक हाइपोगोनाडिज्म. एक्स लिंक्ड है, काल जीन है, इट इज़ एसोसिएटेड विद माइग्रेशन ऑफ GnRH न्यूरॉन्स नहीं हो रहा है फ्रॉम द हाइपोथैलेमिक ऑल्फैक्टरी रीजन टू द हाइपोथैलेमस इटसेल्फ. लॉन्ग टर्म ट्रीटमेंट में उसको GnRH टेस्टोस्टेरॉन और ईस्ट्रोजन प्रोजेस्टेरॉन दे दोगे फॉर सेकेंडरी सेक्शुअल कैरेक्टर्स, एंड फर्टिलिटी के लिए GnRH देना पड़ेगा पोर्टेबल वाया डिलीवरी पम्प, सबक्यूट इन्फ्यूजन पम्प. बार्डेट बीडल इज मेंटली रिटार्डेड, ओबीस, रीनल अबनॉर्मेलिटीज आर देयर, सिनलेक्टल फिंगर्स का सब है, सेंट्रल डायबिटीज इंसिपिडस है इनको, रिटाइनल डिजनरेशन अर्ली, एंड उसमें सिर्फ कलर ब्लाइंडनेस था कालमेन में. और इसमें तो ब्लाइंडनेस बाई एज ऑफ 30. लेप्टिन लेप्टिन रिसेप्टर म्यूटेशन वालों को हाइपरफेजिया एंड ओबेसिटी भी रहेगा अलॉन्ग विद सेंट्रल हाइपोगोनाडिज्म. प्राडरविलर सिंड्रोम इज क्रोमोजोम 15q का पैटर्नल कॉपी ऑफ नेकडिन जीन या SNRPN जीन इज डिलीटेड. तो इसमें भी हाइपरफेजिया, ओबेसिटी, मेंटल रिटार्डेशन, हाइपोटोनिया, डायबिटीज़ मलाइटस है इसमें, ठीक है. बाकी सब जगह पे डायबिटीज़ इंसिपिटस है, लेकिन ये वेसोप्रेसिन प्रोड्यूसिंग न्यूक्लियर भी बोला तो इट कैन बी इंसिपिटस और मलाइटस बोथ, ठीक है. बाकी स्कल, आई, ईयर, हैंड्स एंड डिफेक्ट. सो दिस इज अबाउट द डेवलपमेंटल कॉजेस. नाउ गोइंग टू द अक्वायर्ड कॉजेस ऑफ हाइपोपिट्यूटरिज्म.